Hey guys, a few years ago, I had a chance to go on a weekend retreat, and I'll tell you, it changed me. I was doing a couple of service ministries at that time, and you know, the light of Christ was shared with me. I didn't realize how much my brothers, my faithful brothers, could share the love of Christ through their actions that weekend, and it made me want to serve, you know, at that point. And I can remember about a week later, I'm just looking for something to do. And one of my brothers, it was a chirp retreat, and one of my brothers was telling me about this small group of men, and it was a very small group. It was six or eight guys. And he said, hey, you know, we get together on Saturday mornings at, you know, we sleep in kind of late, and we do it at about 7 o'clock in the morning. And we pray the rosary, and then we have some fellowship and talk about different topics in our faith. And I said, hey, man, that sounds great. Let me check that out. And so I went that next Saturday. And I went, and, you know, it was interesting. You know, guys were ripping each other, just having fun. We prayed the rosary, all that. And you know, and I got home, and my wife says, well, how'd it go? And I said, man, those were good guys, but you know, 7 o'clock in the morning, all that. I just don't think that thing's for me, brothers. That was 4 years ago. I don't think I've missed too many Saturdays. So for whatever reason, the alarm clock doesn't have to go off on Saturday morning, and somehow the car ends up going up to church, and we pray the rosary together, and that group of men has grown from those six or eight guys to, we've got more than 200 guys in the ministry now. And any week, we'll have 50 or 60 guys praying the rosary for and with each other and for others' intentions. And then we have some great fellowship, some refreshments, and then we'll cover a topic of the day. But that all started because there was one man. One man, he made himself available. He didn't worry about the abilities that he had or did not have, and he does have some very good abilities. But he made himself available to Christ, took a leap of faith and said, hey, I don't know if anybody will show up. The first couple of, I think it was two or three guys, the first couple, three meetings they had. And then we started bringing some friends, and this thing's really grown. It's taken off. And there's over 100 of those men here today, okay, this morning. But it all started when one guy was willing to take a leap of faith and do something outside of his comfort zone and start a new ministry for other men to get plugged in, okay? And so it's just a great pleasure for me to be a part of that group. When I think of this man, he has the love and the compassion of Jesus Christ. He's always positive, always has a smile on his face, and he'll uplift you no matter what's going on in his life or your life. He's just that kind of man. He's an eternal optimist. And I think of Matthew 5, chapter 5, verse 14, when I think of this gentleman. You are the light of the world. A city set high on a hill cannot be hidden. Nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others so that they may see your good works and give glory to the Father in heaven. That's what I think of when I think of this man. And he is our speaker moderator for the entire day. You'll be hearing a lot from him, and you'll be glad that you did. And I would like to introduce my friend, Larry West.
Wow. Hey, Paul, if you wouldn't mind tonight after the conference, just come home with me. So when I walk in, you can give that same introduction.
That's awesome.